Welcome back to this series on working with React Data Grid. In my last video, you saw how to bind external data source using the Data Manager and Ajax libraries. In this video, you will see how to enable editing option in the Data Grid, different cell edit options, and customizing the cell edit template. You will also see the different editing modes and how to customize the editing dialog using the custom template. I will open the demo sample which I have created in the Getting Started video. You can get this sample from the link in the description part below or watch the Getting Started video from the link mentioned in the above card. What you now see is the output of this starter code. Here I have loaded the data from the local JSON file and displayed only the selective columns in the data grid. Now I will show you how to enable the editing option in the data grid. You have to first import edit from EJ2 React grids, inject it to the grid component, create a constant of type edit settings model, you can import this from the EJ2 React grids package, create an object with allow editing set to true. Assign this constant to the grid component property edit settings. Now the grid is enabled with the edit option and you can double click any row and edit it. Next, I will show you how to enable the toolbar with add and edit options. You have to import toolbar and toolbar items from EJ2 React grids package. Inject toolbar to the grid component. Create a constant of type toolbar items array. And add the items add, edit, delete, update, and cancel to the array. Assign this constant to the toolbar props of the grid component. Also enable allow adding and allow deleting in the edit options. Now the grid is enabled with a toolbar with edit options. You can add a new record with the add button. Edit a record with the edit button. And delete a record using the delete button. Okay, when you edit a record in the grid, you will notice that only text boxes are enabled for all the cells, even cells with numeric values. I will show you how to display the appropriate controls on each columns by using different cell edit types available in the grid component. By default, grid supports the following cell edit types: numeric text box, drop-down list, checkbox, date picker, and daytime picker. You can also add your own custom component to the cell edit type, which I will show you later in this video. You can change the cell edit type through the props edit type of each individual column directive. For country, set it to dropdown edit. For freight, set it to numeric edit. For you to see the date picker, I will add order date column to the grid. Set its edit type to date picker edit and format to year month date to set the display format of the column. In the output, while editing the grid, you will get the drop-down list for the ship country column, numeric text box for the column freight, and date picker for the order date column. Next, I will show you how to add custom components to the cell edit option. For this, I will use a masked text box in the phone number column. As this column actually doesn't exist, you will have to create one. Update the local data source with the phone numbers. And using the column directive, enable the column for phone number in the grid. As the masked textbox component is present in EJ2 React inputs package, install it using the command npm install at syncfusion/EJ2-react-inputs. Import the masked textbox component from EJ2 React inputs. create a function edit template and return the masked text box with the following mask and ID as phone number. Here the 0 represents the numeric digit. To know more about the masked text box, visit our documentation page. Assign this function to the edit template property of the corresponding column directive. Now in the output, if you edit the phone number cell, you will see the masked text box being displayed. Next, let me show you the different editing modes supported by the grid component. The default mode is the normal mode, which edits the value of the selected row in line. The batch mode allows you to edit the rows in a batch. You can enable this by setting the edit mode to batch. Now edit multiple records at a time and update those records in a single update. The dialog mode allows you to edit the records using a built-in dialog. You can set this in the mode property of the edit options. I am removing the update and cancel toolbar options as the dialog will have the save and cancel buttons by default. So when editing a record, the dialog will pop up for editing. As a last section of this video, I will show you how to customize the dialog with the custom template option using the template property of the grid component. This template will apply for both the normal inline and dialog mode. In this video, I will start with the dialog mode. Before starting to define this template function, I will create a new file named ordermodel.tsx and add an interface for the order data. This will help keep my code as strongly typed. Now, a new function has to be created by passing the order model as args in the app component. Here I will return the custom template, which I will create in a moment. Now let me move on to the creation of the custom template design. For that, I will create a new file under the src folder and name it as dialogformtemplate.tsx. Then I will initiate the function component and return the template which we are going to create now. Before defining the template, the package Syncfusion/ej2-react dropdowns will have to be installed, as I will be using the component dropdown list from this package in my custom template design. Because I am going to design the template using Bootstrap, Bootstrap styles have to be imported in the app.css file. The props here will receive details about the selected grid row, which I will use in the template. In the first row, I will add two columns, one for order ID and another for customer ID. I will bind the corresponding value properties of the template to the order ID and customer ID props of the component by using the code props.orderID and props.customerID. The orderID field should be enabled only when adding new records to the grid. If you want to edit an existing record, the orderID field should be displayed in the read-only mode as it is the primary key of the grid. This logic can be simply defined by checking the isAddBoolean property for the orderID field. In the second row, add a numeric text box for changing the value of the fright column and bind props.fright with the value property of the template. Add dropdown list for ship country column. To populate the dropdown list items, you can create your own custom logic here. For this sample, I will get distinct country values from the order list using the data util from ej2data package. Set the ship country of the props to the value property of the template. In the third row, I will add the ship address column and bind it with the ship address props to the value property of the template. Import this dialog form template to the app component and return it from the dialog template function. Assign this function to the template props of the edit option, and you will see the custom template displayed when editing a row. This custom template is also applicable to the normal mode. I will change the mode to normal, and you will see the custom template displayed when editing a row. Let me summarize some of the major points discussed in this video. First, we saw how to enable the editing feature of the grid along with its toolbar options. Next, we saw the different celery types supported in the grid component and how to add a custom cell edit template. Then we saw the different modes of editing. Finally, we saw how to add the custom templates to the dialog and normal editing modes in the grid component. Thanks for watching this video. If you find this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.